you hear that, the really high-pitched, annoying coil whine type sound coming from my motherboard? Well, no, I can't either because this isn't plugged in. But what some people have actually found is that after upgrading their motherboard or building a new computer or whatever, there's a really annoying high-pitched sound and it seems to be coming from their motherboard. That can be known as coil whine, and that's where the actual electrical current is passing through a capacitor or a coil or something like that, and in some cases, it can cause a coil whine. In general, you'd think the motherboards can never cause coil whine type sounds or anything like that, and it must be something else. You know, it must be the graphics card or something like that, and that would be the first place to look. But if maybe you've removed the graphics card and any other PCI Express cards, and you're still getting an annoying high-pitched whine, it could actually be coming from the motherboard, and it all comes down to silicon lottery, really. You might just have a bad or noisy motherboard, which is causing coil whine, and it's incredibly annoying. But what some people have found is if you go into your BIOS, or maybe the Windows settings, and you disable any power saving type settings, in some cases that can then fix the coil whine. For some reason, it seems like some motherboards, especially with Gigabyte for some reason, in power saving mode, they can sometimes actually have coil whine type symptoms and things like that. But that is something to check, but I just wanted to do this video because some people are driven crazy by some high-pitched sound coming from their computer, and everyone tells them it couldn't possibly be the motherboard, but actually it can be, which is incredibly annoying. So if you've ruled out all other causes like your graphics card and maybe a loose fan bearing and things like that, if you've ruled out all of that, then yes, it could actually be the motherboard, in which case then, as I said, try and play with the settings, but worst case you might need to look at RMAing the motherboard. And I wish I had better news for you, but that wraps up this short video. I hope you found it useful at least. If you did, please click the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.